VC. Thanks for tuning in. Look what we got here. The package from the Elusive Disc. Yeah, you remember last time I ordered some records from Music Direct. Music Direct, this is the box I got. Come in. Yeah, look at this joker, this is nice. Elusive Disc, I ordered a bunch of records from Music Direct because they actually owed me money for a record I sent back. It was like about a $45 record. So I had $45 on my account there. And so I figured, well, I ordered some more records, you know. So that's why I got one there. But as y'all know, when I went to order the records, most of the ones I wanted, they didn't have it. So I went to the Elusive Disc. I checked all the records I wanted, and I went to all in stock. Got the whole bunch I wanted. And look at this. Look how they've got that packed in there. Tell me that's not going over the top. These people here, they want to make sure the records, you're getting your records the way you bought them. Mint condition. That's what I like. The people that go the extra mile for you. That's awesome. I love this box. This is really, really nice. Yeah, you ever seen anybody on eBay packing a box like this? Except maybe me? Because I'm going to use this again. Okay. So what do we have in here? There's a hint, actually. Yeah, there's a hint going happening right now. And if the copyright police, they want to get after me about that, go right ahead. I can just delete this little unboxing video. You know, there's another thing. You know, because I had a credit, I couldn't just go online and buy the record. I actually had to call them up and talk to a fellow on the phone. And when I did, I said, send me a book of your catalog for your records and stuff. Yeah, I'll do that. They didn't do it. And I didn't even ask the Elusive Disc. They sent me a catalog. You know, these are nice. They've got all the records they've got there you can look through. You know, trying to navigate the websites are okay, but this is nice. I really appreciate that. Okay, so what do we have in the box? Y'all tuned in for. What is going on here? Okay. Nice packaging. Okay. So, let's put this here. And look at this. This is the Yes box. Yeah, look how nice that is. And this is the, according to Music Direct, this is a waiting repress. So, and it's a, see, I have the computer right here. You can click on it. First you have to find it. There it is. It is the 45th anniversary limited edition 180 gram 45 RPM mastered by Friday Music's Joe Rigoso from the original Atlantic tapes. See, that's the kind of stuff, when you read that, you know you're in for something special. So that's going to be great. And then I bought this, not because I'm a big Eagles fan, but I know there's a lot of other Eagles fans out there. And this is the reissues that have come out. So I've got one of these, and I've got, you know, I've got the Japanese original press of this so I can compare. Oh yeah, there we go. This is another one of them records. I'm not a big Judas Priest fan, but this is number 1572. It's that silver label again. And I did have a subscriber say that he said that these sounded really nice, better than the Japanese press. Well, I'm really skeptical about these silver label. But hey, let's do the comparison. Let's see how it's gonna work out for us. We got the record. And guess what else they had over there? They had the Rush. The new Rush, the 200 gram audiophile vinyl. Now, what I liked about this, now I had a fella said he got one and he didn't really think it, he didn't really like it. He wanted my opinion. What I like about it, they're 200 gram vinyl reissued, pressed at quality record pressings. Direct metal mastered from the original analog masters at Abbey Road Studios. So we know if it's not up to par, it's nothing to do with quality records. And it's from the original analog master. I was thinking about this. Rush, they're a Canadian band. Why are they getting their records done at Abbey Road Studios? They were recorded, the first LP I was reading last night was recorded in it was in Quebec they recorded the record. So, I mean, I don't understand that. Why wouldn't they go to a, like Quality Records, but it's probably got something to do with Mercury Records and all that stuff, you know. But anyway, I don't see why this shouldn't be great. But, and I know that the, doing direct metal mastering is not easy. That's a hard process. But, you know, one thing that I don't like is this digital download card. You can get a, it comes with the digital download card. Well, how did they make the digital, how did they get that digital? From what? The tape? And then what did they do with that tape, that digital information? Yeah, that's the scary part. I'm really skeptical of records that come with download cards. In my experience is most of those ones that are digital, there's a digital record. So anyway, we'll find out. We're gonna find out about that. And as promised, we got Yes Close to the Edge. And this one, Friday Music. And we just saw this the other day. Boy, that's really, really pretty on there. They really get this nice color. Really nice color on this one compared to the Japanese ones that we were looking at the other day. But the cover is nice. But you know, this is not a 1972 cover. They could have done a little bit better job with the cover. But I mean, it's still nice. It's not paper thin or anything. It's still nice. And we've got the nice inner sleeve, original inner sleeve. But it's kind of smooth on the inside. It's not poly-lined though. But it's smooth, but of course I'll have to do something about that right away. I'm not even gonna take the record out of there. Now, the deal with this one, I gotta go to it. There it is. This one is 180 gram audiophile vinyl, half speed mastered by Friday Music's Joe Ragoso from the original master tapes. This is half speed mastered. I also got off eBay. I went to eBay and because I looked at Music Direct and a couple of, now I think that the Elusive Disc has it. I think I saw it last night. But the Rhino reissue, I bought that too. It's on the way, it's in the mail. So I'm gonna compare this half speed master to the Rhino reissue, which is from the original analog tape as well. And I've got that Japanese first edition too. So I've got three. So that's gonna be great. Gonna be a little shootout there. And you hear that little jazz action going on in the background. And here it is. Herbie Hancock Headhunters. The record that's playing is from a reissue that was done on the Sony Legacy label a couple years ago. And I had for, you know, since the record came out, I had it on a Canadian press. And this one, the one that I've got on, sounded a little bit better. Not a lot, but a little bit. But this one now. Yeah, look at this. Yeah. Original master tape. Quality record pressings. Unmatched quality. Meticulous test pressing. Deluxe packaging. Limited to less than 1,000 records per stamper. Very nice. Let's pop the top on this thing. See what's under the hood. Oh boy, look at that. Boy, is that ever nice. Look at the camera. I don't know if you can see it or not. Kind of move it, maybe you can get a little reflection off of that. Wow. That's high quality there. That is a nice, just like the T for the Tillerman and all that. And then the back is not shiny, but it's still nice and thick. You know, Friday music, come on. Look how nice quality records is putting out their stuff. That's a nice thick cover. This record never came in a cover this nice and this thick. Ever. We got the little book in there. And then it comes on the original Columbia label that it came out on. And look at the nice inner sleeve Friday music. That one you got, I'm gonna have to put it in one of the record sleeves like this. So it's nice when you, and I know the record sounds gonna sound phenomenal. Just a matter of time before we get into that part of it. We can look that one up. Got it here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. Now this one, Herbie Hancock, it says 200 gram vinyl mastered at Sterling Sound. That's the same place they did the T for the Tillerman. Cat Stevens record by Ryan Smith. Exclamation mark. Pressed at Quality Record Pressings. So yeah, wow. Really nice. This just makes a person happy when you see this, such a beautiful, nice record like that. You know, a record that you love, you really like, and they just take such, they treat it with the same kind of love like that. That's awesome. So I'm gonna put this on right away after y'all, I turn the camera off, we're gonna be listening to this. And then, look at this. Mott the Hoople, All the Young Dudes. Mott the Hoople, All the Young Dudes. Little sticker on there. Mastered for vinyl by Kevin Gray at Coherent Audio. It says something about the artwork. That's Super Vinyl 200 gram. Oh yeah, look at that. It's the same as the, yeah, you know why too. Let's move this over here. That's why I got it, because I got a bunch of stuff on here now. I'm gonna sit through it all. Here it is. Numbered limited edition. Here it is, 357 of 1,000, okay? You know, that's a great record. They're only making 1,000 of these records. Unbelievable. Numbered limited edition, 200 gram black vinyl, only 1,000 copies, mastered by Kevin Gray and pressed at Quality Record Pressings. And look at that beautiful Quality Records cover. Shiny on both sides of it. And here's the Quality Records again on the Columbia label. Wow. Really nice job. No, it doesn't have that big hype sticker that the other one had about, you know, meticulous and this and that and from the original master tapes. But looks really good. Quality records pressing. So I do have a Japanese edition of this, so you know we're gonna be comparing it to something that's really good. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll be getting down and we'll be listening to these records now, and I'll be getting back to you with another couple, probably another couple, at least couple, two, three videos for all these records, and let you know how it all turned out.